Hey man, how many of y'all know Job loved the Lord? And he told the Lord, he told his friend, even though God slayed him, he'll still trust him. Amen? And how many of y'all have that same mindset on today? Amen. We know Job done went through so much. He went through his kids, you know, dying. His wife telling them, curse your God and you gonna just die. He lost his animals. But how many know y'all, when God do things like that, God just trying to see where your faith at. But God already knew where Job was. He was just trying to let the devil know. The devil thought he had Job, but he ain't have him. Wow. Amen, amen, amen. Can somebody read me the first through the first and the eighth verse? Job 1 and 8.
And the Lord said unto Satan, cast out his spirit my servant Job, that there is none like him in the earth, a perfect and an upright man, one that fears God and eschews evil.
Amen, amen. Can God say that about us? One that fears God and shuns evil. One that's blameless and upright. Because see, sometimes we let circumstances and things just get us. But God knew that he could trust Job and knew where Job's faith was at. So the question is today, where is your faith at? Amen, amen, amen. Because God already knew what the devil was up to. The devil was roaming, seeking who he may devour, trying to find somebody. And God told the devil, go ahead and try, don't touch the man. But you can do whatever you want to do. So the devil thought he was going to get Job. But Job had another story coming for him. I want you to just read at the 8th verse one more time.
And the Lord said unto Satan, hast thou considered my servant Job, that there is none like him in the earth, a perfect and an upright man, one that feareth God and eschews evil.
So see, Satan's goal was to prove Job ought to be a sinner, but God knew not so. Can God say the same thing about us? How many know you, when we go through our trials and our tribulations and our tests and stuff like that, sometimes it's hard to stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. I'm going to tell the truth. It be hard sometimes. But how many of y'all know that when God, when it's a test in front of us, God going to bring us out? How many of y'all know when it's trials and tribulations in front of us, or we in it, God going to bring us out? God going to bring us through. Because my favorite scripture, one of them, is yea, do I walk through, which means you're going to come out. Yeah. In the end, you're going to come out. And Job had lost his kids, his family, his stuff. It seemed like he lost his wife, too, because she told him to curse your God and die. But how many of y'all know that God was right there with Job? He was right there all the time with Job, standing right there in the midst. And how many of y'all know when we take a test, the teacher is present in the building, but they just don't say nothing. That's how God be with us. We going through every wind and wave trying to blow us away, but God be right there. The test that come up on us is to prove that we can trust and believe in God. And that's what God looking for, somebody to have that faith, knowing that he's right there with us all the time. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. When you going through and people in your ear, it's time for you to get on your knees and say, God, this ain't my problem, but this is your problem.
That's right.
God knows that he's with us, and we need to know that he's with us, because he said he won't never leave us or forsake us. So it's time for us to put our faith and our eyes on God for real, not for faith. Because see, it's easy, like my mama like to say, it's easy to sit there and praise God when everything going your way, when everything going all right. But the thing is, when we in that valley, do we grow? Is our faith increasing? Are we sitting there trusting and believing that God going to bring us out for real, not for faith? See, because we can always give other people encouraging words, but can we really encourage ourselves to stand in God? Because God is looking for people that's going to stand in these last and evil days, whose faith is going to be greater than a mustard seed. Because we're going to have to help people out. Amen. We say we're standing in the Lord. So when things come our way, we're going to have to be able to stand. Amen. Amen. And not only stand, but also stand without complaining and trust God. Job ain't complain. Job said, though he slay me, yet will I still trust him. Because he knew who God was. Do you have a relationship with God on God the author and the finisher of your faith. Amen. If so, then you got a right to sit there and stand knowing that God is right along with you. Amen. Philippians 4:11 says, amen, Philippians 4:11 says, not that I speak in regard to need, for I have learned in whatever state I am in to be content. I wonder how Job was feeling when all that happened to him. I can tell you one thing. I thank God it wasn't me, because I'd have probably lost my mind. I don't know what I would have did. And then his wife right there, just say for instance, his flesh was saying, you know what, God ain't real. And his wife said, curse your God and die. He could have sat there and cursed God and sat there and died. But Job sat there and stood on his faith knowing that God was going to bring him out. And at the end of the chapter, I think God has done, gave him back everything plus more. And sometimes that's what God wants to show us, that he got just what we need. When the enemy tries to throw things at us and try to stop us in our walk with him, God is showing us that he has just what we need to finish this race. Amen. Job knew that God was a real man, a real God. He knew that God had his back no matter what. He knew that the enemy was out to kill him. He knew. Amen. So can God consider us? And I looked up the word consider, and it says thought about or decided upon with care or well chosen. Well chosen. Can God choose us to say, you know what, Satan, go try to attack my sister, my daughter, Evangelist Jones. Go try to attack my son, Pastor Jones. Go try to attack him, because he know that he chose you to stand. Amen? Amen. So that's my encouraging word on today. That y'all just stand in y'all faith and stand up and allow and know and let everybody know that God is real. Amen. Because some people, y'all might be the only Bible people open. When they look at you, they looking to see.